Put your hands together for Chrissie Swan.
Nice. Thank you for having me.
Tell us, you walked here. You walked to the studio, right?
I did not walk to the studio, oh, no. No, I didn't. No, I came straight from work. My national radio show on Nova. Got the plug in!
You got it.
Now everyone will be so happy with me at work.
You're in the middle of August and you're 200 kilometres down already. That's amazing.
Yes, I've got 10 days and 100 kilometres to go. And, I mean, most people... I was just looking... I was in the green room looking up the charity. Most people do 50, 100 or 150 kilometres. I cannot tell you why I've chosen to do 300. And this is the third year I've done it. And I've done it the last two and I'm by crikey, I'm going to do it again.
How's the body feeling? Are your feet sore?
Well, really good, but I have added an extra degree of difficulty and I've bought some arm weights.
Oh!
So now...
Why?
Oh, because I'm a sucker for punishment, Lolly.
So you're doing these ones?
Well, it's very embarrassing because... I mean, I don't care what people think of me. That's the first thing you need to know. But I walk like this. And it makes your face go weird and stuff. And then it gets very heavy. And then I rest for a bit and then I start
and you
going.
Get back into it,
and I'm walking for 2 hours a day. So the arms are a bit sore.
Ever been arrested doing that?
What?
It looks sort of weird. Careful.
Not doing that. I have not been arrested doing that.
Excellent. Would you like to detail all of the things you have been arrested for?
No, I haven't got time.
Roll the credits and I'll talk.
I haven't seen any of this malarkey on your Instagram. I follow a lot. But a lot of your walking journeys on there.
Yeah.
How do you know? Because I think everyone struggles to get up and get into it sometimes. How do you motivate yourself to get up and get into
it? Yeah, well, this is the thing. I've never moved my body my whole life, ever. I never exercised. I hated sport growing up, was just not interested. And I just thought, well, that's not for me.
Yeah.
I'm never going to find anything that I enjoy. And then I started walking one day and I haven't stopped. But the biggest tip, I think, is don't worry about what people think about what you look like. Put your runners on first thing and then do that every single day, regardless of what you're wearing. Like today I had a suit on and my walking shoes, because I don't care. I need to get those kilometres or, you know, I'm going to embarrass myself in front of the entire nation.
Did COVID start this? Am I right to remember that? When COVID was around and we couldn't do anything?
Yes, we couldn't do anything. And that was, I didn't really, I mean, obviously I knew about the Fred Hollows Foundation, but I saw an ad on Instagram and I thought, oh, that sounds good. That's like something that I could do.
Yeah.
So I just did it off my own bat and I've just, everyone's gotten behind me and I've saved thousands of people's eyesight.
It's
I mean,
amazing.
Properly saved it. Yeah, it's amazing.
The work they do is amazing.
It's extraordinary.
It has been for ages.
And it's only $25 to save somebody's... from avoidable blindness.
That's extraordinary. Crazy.
It's extraordinary.
I have to ask you about the backpack.
Yeah.
So you're always walking... Not just the weights. You've always got a backpack.
Yeah. In that one, that was two ham and salad rolls for my friend. I walked them into the city.
Right. So you're basically Uber walks.
Yeah, like a chuck truck. truck on my back. The day before that, I had 4 kilos of frozen peas in there.
Oh.
And not for the weights. People are like, oh, do you have weights in your bag? I'm like, no, that's shopping. I make a great pea soup. Needed the frozen. Day before, I had 2 pairs of school shorts for my kids in there. The backpack starts empty. And then I just, and I work out where I'm going and I fill it up with peas and rolls.
So errands.
Yeah.
It's just errands.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
When you're not walking, you're going to be very busy with The Masked Singer, which is back on our screens very, very soon. And we hear that you had to face a bit of an intervention on this latest season. Let's have a look.
Yeah.
I'm so happy to see you back here. Welcome back, Chrissie Swan, everyone.
I can't tell you I'm beside myself to be here.
Last time we did this, Chrissie, your alter ego kind of took over your life. CSI Swan showed up.
No. This year, I am not going to lose my mind and I have just resisted already stalking people on Instagram.
Chrissie, you will burn out, all right? I'm the only original person on this desk because I've never tried.
So are you phoning in the guesses this season?
No, I was really good until about halfway through and then I was... up at night like a serial killer. Yeah. Yeah.
Did you pick the lead?
I had one of those, you know, all these photos of celebrities joined by threads, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can I tell you, don't panic, 10 publicity. I'm not going to give anything away. But one of the reveals, sometimes when I'm feeling sad, I just go back to that moment that the mask comes off and I'm so happy.
Ah. Is that you?
It is mind-blowing.
I can't...
I said it was mind-blowing, not average. Donate to Chrissie's Big Walk. All the info's on our website. Put your hands together for this lovely lady.
Thank you for having me.